the most commonly used classification, which was proposed by Edward Kennedy in 1920. So the classification is based on the relationship of indigenous space to the natural. It classified all the arches into four main types. Class 1, bilateral indigenous area located posterior to the remaining natural. Class 2, unilateral indigenous area located posterior to the remaining natural. Class 3, unilateral indigenous area with natural teeth both anterior and posterior. Class 4, a single but bilateral indigenous space crossing the midline located anterior to the remaining natural. The figures are given here, the picture is given here. This is class 1. It's a bilateral indigenous area located posterior to the remaining. The posterior area is indigenous. On either side, it is bilateral. In this case, it is bilateral. If it is unilateral, it is called class 1. So, unilateral indigenous space with natural teeth remaining anterior to the space. Class 3. So, unilateral indigenous area with teeth remaining and anterior and posterior to the space. Then comes the class 4. Class 4 is a single space, but it is crossing the midline. It is crossing the midline and the location is anterior to the remaining. The applicants' rules for applying the Kennedy's classification in all the situations. So, what are the rules? Rule 1, classification should follow rather than proceed any extractions of teeth that might alter the original classification. Rule 2, if a dead molar is missing and not to be replaced, is not considered the classification. Rule 3, if a premolar is missing and is to be replaced as an abutment, it is considered the classification. Rule 4, if a second molar is missing and not to be replaced, it is not considered the classification. Rule 5, the most posterior indigenous area always determines the classification. Rule 6, indigenous area other than those determined by classification are referred to as modification spaces. Rule 7, the extent of the modification is not considered, only an additional indigenous area is considered. Rule 8, there can be no modification areas in class 4. So considering the fact the applicant's rules for classifying the Kennedy's, applying the Kennedy's classification. When you see this, this is a class 3. Okay. So, what about this? The most posterior indigenous area always determines the classification. But first, we have to consider the most posterior indigenous area. So, when you consider this two area, it will become class 1. Okay. Then, in addition to this space, there is one more space in the anterior area. So that additional indigenous area is referred to as modification space. Okay. Only one modification space is there, then it is the classification is class 1, modification 1. If it is more than one, if there are two additional indigenous area, then it is class 1, modification 2. And when you have to classify this one, you can see, first we have to consider the most posterior indigenous area, that is, this is the area that you have to consider. When you consider this area, what it is class 3, okay, that is, deep remaining anterior and posterior indigenous. So first we have to consider the most posterior indigenous area. So So when you consider this area, it will become plastic. Then additional to this area, one more area is there. That is referred to as modification space. So it is called plastic modification. What about this? This is which classification? Class 2. Modification 1. What about this one? Class 3. Modification 2. Okay. This is the most posterior in this area. When you consider this two areas, this is the most posterior. So this first we consider only this area. So that will be class 3. Okay. So after considering that area, then additional two more areas has to be considered, that are referred to as modification space. Okay. So it is class 3 modification 2. What about this one? This is which classification? Class 3 modification 1. It is not class 4. There is no modification area. Rule number 8. There is no modification area in class 4. So when first additional to this area comes posterior to this area, then that will be the classification. So when you consider this one, it is class 3 modification 1. So the classification, two more classification is there in genitals, and additional edentulous area, counter, anterior and posterior by natural teeth, in which the anterior abutment is not suitable for support. That is class 5. Class 6, additional and edentulous area, in which the teeth adjacent to the space are capable of total support of the required processes. Okay. So that is about genetics classification. Now the components of the major conductor we will consider.